or punishment? How do we get kids to do what we ask? Psychologist Dr. Lana Coffey is here to tips on today's Keiki Talk. Very interesting topic, very controversial.
Yes, yeah.
Because many people believe discipline teaches and punishments penalize and uses retribution. Your thoughts on both?
Right, yeah. Right. It is very controversial, and I'm very cautious when I talk about this, but I think it's important because many people come to therapy, many parents come asking us, what do we do to get this child to behave one way or the other? So discipline, I tell them, you know, discipline, the value of that is it's teaching, and we know that when we teach a child a skill that's internalized and that child can do that skill whether we're there or not, whereas punishment requires an external imposing of some sort of penalty, and that always requires another person be present.
And that's the key. Yeah. Oh, so why use nonviolent parenting? And of course, there are ways to discipline without spanking.
Right. So we know that children, this is back from Martin Hoffman. He was very much interested in studying empathy and pro-social behavior in young people. So he came up with these five. The first one is our role. Right. As the adult, as auntie, as mother, as teacher, that's why you should do what I say. But I think this began to erode in the 60s when we had so many youth protests and the adult's authority was questioned. It also changed again. We had stranger danger, and we began to teach our children not all the adults can be trusted. So authority began to erode. We also use our resources. We control the money, the electricity, the internet. We can control those resources of the children, and we use those as reinforcers. Be careful not to restrict them for too long. I took away a skateboard. My son forgot he had the skateboard, and it lost its value as a reinforcer. We also use power assertion, actually. And power assertion is, you know, could be spanking, but we try to not open hand strike a child, but it's picking them up, moving them, putting them where we want them to be. And in some cases, it's actually moving in closer and using our body just to impose our presence. Also, we use love withdrawal. Now, that's not my term. That's Hoffman's term. I would never suggest anybody withdraw love from a child. But what he meant by that is that we be honest with our feelings with the children. You've disappointed me, you've frustrated me, and so I'm going to show it in my face and my words. We're no longer sweet.
Yeah.
And then finally, induction. Induction is what he felt was the most important tool in teaching children empathy, and that's because it's the teaching piece. It's the part where I explain to you how your behavior has affected me and our community.
So those are the five ways of not spanking your child, discipline without spanking.
Yes.
And these days, I mean, you've heard it, my friends have joked about it, but their friends' children say, if you spank me, I'm going to call the government.
Yes.
I mean, but back when I was young, you know, that was part of life, but it's still very touchy, very controversial.
Yeah. Well, you know, we all, I think, have had dirty lickings of some sort, varying degrees, right? But I think that if we look at plants, and I think of kids like plants, sometimes I think of them as like puppies, but like plants, and a good gardener knows when a plant needs more sun and when more plant needs more shade, and we are flexible with that, and we don't force the shady plant into the sun nor the sunny plant into the shade, but we adapt to the child's needs.
And let them bloom.
Hopefully.
Turn them loose. Hopefully you did it right, all that you needed to do, right?
All right.
Thank you very much. Have a
You're
great
welcome.
Weekend. Some people, though, still need dirty lickings, right? We all heard that. 7:21, coming up next, expect the change. I'm joking. Expect the change in the weather over the weekend. Ties will have our extended weather forecast. Also, just ahead, another Hawaii fighter.